Thank you very much for coming. Welcome to the fourth annual Dick Cypress Research Symposium. I'm surprised this is the fourth annual, but I've gotten to the habit. And because I've gotten to the habit, I'm a little lax in a couple of details. These name tags, you might have guessed, really meant to be name tags. They don't stick on everybody's shirts, but I do appreciate it. If you don't already have a name tag, it helps me remember people's names. I'm Jim Snyder. And I managed to come down with kind of a scratchy throat yesterday in anticipation of today's meeting, I think. But the format's the same as we've had in years past, although this year we're going on 20-minute intervals rather than 15-minute intervals, and hopefully the speakers will allow us to have maybe 2 minutes or so for questions at the end of their talks. If there's insufficient time, they have lots of questions, please be sure to get them with the break, because we try to build in a lot of breaks, because I think interaction is one of the important things about this meeting. To kick things off, I'd like to introduce the superintendent of Dick Cypress National Reserve, Pedro Ramos.
The superintendent gets blamed for a lot of things. I thought you were going to blame me for the coffee, so I'm glad that you didn't. It's good to know that there's coffee back there. Weather's turning. My voice is feeling it, so I apologize for that. It is my pleasure to welcome everybody to the fourth annual Science Symposium. Who would have thunk? Welcome to Big Cypress National Reserve. This is a really important event that we have now annually, thanks to Dr. Snyder. It has got to be one of the favorite events that I participate in every year and I get the opportunity to be part of. And we're very proud to be partnering with USGS in this particular project. I can't thank you enough, Jim, for your leadership and your vision. This was your baby. You felt...
I'm really waiting for grandchildren.
Yeah, well, I can't help you on that one. But I will say that it was a wonderful, wonderful vision. I think a legacy that you will leave behind at some point in time, not that I'm expecting you to retire anytime soon. But, you know, this is the kind of lasting work that is meaningful that I think we all aim to do in any of the work that we put our minds to. So, hey, Jim, with that, I'd like to ask you to come up here. I've got a brand new superintendent's coin that we give to special people that are doing special things that make an impact and a difference in the work that we do, not just in the National Park Service down here, and in particular, Big Cypress National Reserve, but also in this entire ecosystem that we care so much about. So thank you very much, Jim. Just don't go try to use it at a store. It's not gonna buy you anything. No, in all seriousness, there's very few things that we do and that we deal with that are as important as science. Science is critical to the work that we do. There's a lot of things that inform the decisions that we make, and God knows that we make very difficult decisions. And we have got to make every effort to continue investing the amount of attention and resources that we have been investing. And this room speaks for itself. There's a lot of tremendous amount of good work that is taking place down here in Southwest Florida in particular. And we appreciate every effort that you're making. I'm gonna share a little story with you, and it's not gonna take very long, but I think it emphasizes the importance of science in the work that we do. Last night, in this very same room, we were here until 8 o'clock, running an off-road vehicle advisory committee meeting. It's a group of people that have been appointed by the Secretary of Interior, Secretary Salazar, to advise us on an issue that is very contentious in the work that we do here at Big Cypress, off-road vehicle management. how do we allow those machines to traverse through the back country and at the same time ensure the protection of the special resource. And the meeting last night was pretty close to a train wreck, if it was ever one. We've been at this now since 2007, and there has been contentious meetings in the past. The nature of the composition of the committee is very diverse. Deliberately, we want all voices to be at the table advising us on this work that we have to do. And last night, there was a lot of tension because there's litigation going on. And there was a number of members of the committee that took exception and felt very strongly about another member of the committee that is involved in litigation with us and has been now for years from another organization that partners with us in a lot of great work as well, not only here but throughout the country. And they felt that he should have not been on the table, that it was a conflict. Some of them were downright disgusted by the fact that he was sitting at the table at the same time as he was going to the judge for answers that he may have not been getting around this table last night. And I have no doubt that we will overcome the kind of environment that we saw around that table last night and do the good work that we have to do moving forward. That team is committed to the issues that we're working on. They are all at that table because regardless of what their opinion is, they care deeply about this place, whether they're an environmentalist or whether they're a hunter and they want to use machines to get to their destinations. But as I was driving home last night, I was just racking my brain trying to figure out what would make this right. What type of information, what type of thinking we bring to the mix that will resolve a lot of the conflict and a lot of the tension that we all have. And you know what? Science will. More science, and science that is relevant and specific to the topics and the questions that we are grappling with, in this case, related to off-road vehicle use and its impacts on this environment. That would make things a lot easier, and I think it would help people, even folks that don't see eye to eye, come closer to each other, because science has that effect. So I just want to commend you for the work that you do. I hope that I did my job in doing what I wanted to do, coming in here, visiting for 5 minutes with you, in highlighting the importance of the work that you do, and sharing with you how much we appreciate all of the effort that you make helping us as managers, as well as the public, understand the fact about these places that we care so much about. So keep up the good work. Welcome to Big Cypress, and enjoy the fourth annual symposium. Thanks.